chance. It's Swiss Maverick. Welcome to part two of the editor tutorial. In the first part, I explained you guys how to use the toolbar here on the right side. So I explained you the different areas here and what they do. And in this tutorial here, we're gonna look. We're gonna go a bit deeper into things. I'm gonna show you how to create units, how to set the parameters for them. Yeah, we'll look at groups, triggers, waypoints. Sorry, stupid phone. And yeah, some more stuff that you should afterwards be able to like create your own small missions. Yeah, for you to play or share with friends or whatever. Okay, we're gonna start with the units. I can either here click on units or press F1 to select this category, and then I can just go somewhere on the map where I want to place this unit, and I double click on that, and then this insert unit screen or window appears, and here I can select a lot of different parameters. So it starts here with the side, blue 4, op 4, independent, civilian, or ambient life, which is like animals and stuff. I'm just gonna go with blue 4 now. Then the second window here, or the second thing here, is the faction. It's selected USMC now. This is the Chechen units, US units from Operation Arrowhead. No, that's not true. This is from ARMA, I think. The US units this year is the Chechen units, if I'm right. Never used the stuff. BAF is British Armed Forces from the expansion, German units, and Pakistani locals. I'm just gonna go with USMC. Then here class, I can select man, which is like infantryman, air vehicles, armored vehicles, car, and then objects, fortifications, fortifications. So there you get some stuff to create yourself a base or something. Then I got the man force recon from the original ARMA game. I get the navy man, which is like the carrier crew from ARMA. I get ships, static, which are like static machine guns, mortars, artillery and stuff. Support vehicles like repair trucks, fuel trucks and stuff. And targets, so if I'm doing like a training map, I can create some targets here. Warfare buildings, that's for the warfare game mode. Alright, so I'm just gonna stick with man. Then here control, so important. If I'm doing a single player mission, I get either non-playable, which is like every AI character. I can select player, which is gonna be the character I am playing. And then I get playable. So if I have multiple different units, and I select one unit as player, I'm gonna spawn at as this unit. So I'm gonna be the player of this unit. And if I have another unit selected playable, I can use the team switch option within the game to switch from one character to another. So this can be a lot of fun. I can switch like from air support to ground to ground support, so from a tank to an A-10 or whatever. So that's how you use this here in single player. In multiplayer, you want to select every unit that should be playable or selectable in the multiplayer lobby should be playable here, or has to be playable here. And if you have 20 units on your map which are selected playable, you can afterwards in multiplayer have 20 players using these bots. I'm doing single player now, so I just select player. The info edge is not really important. I can't even tell you what it does, because I never used it, and yeah, can't tell you. So unknown is alright. Vehicle lock, if I'm creating a vehicle, I can select I can select that it is unlocked, default or locked. Usually it's default, which means it's unlocked, so if the vehicle is empty, I can get in as player. If I select it to locked, I cannot go into the vehicle. So if you need that, if you want to set the parameter for your mission, you can do that. I'm just gonna leave it to unlock now. It's just only for vehicles, obviously, not for infantry units. Here the rank goes from private to colonel. This is important when you're creating a group, which I'm gonna show you right after this. The character or the unit in a group that has the highest rank is automatically gonna be the group leader, obviously. But that's not important yet. Then I get here a unit. When I have here blue 4 USMC man, here I get the types of man, of infantrymen that are available in this faction. So I can have an AA specialist, corpsman, whatever. I'm gonna go with corpsman. Alright. Special here. If I have also a group and I choose information, this means every unit is gonna spawn in, usually the default formation is the V formation. So every unit is gonna spawn in the V formation and afterwards proceed towards the first waypoint if I give a waypoint to the group. If I select none, the unit is gonna spawn exactly where I have placed it. And if I have a group with a vehicle, maybe mechanized infantry patrol with an LAV 25 or so and a couple of soldiers and the team leader, and I select every unit in cargo, at mission start the whole group will be sitting in the back of the vehicle. So I can select that if I want. I can also go in game and then mount up to the vehicle, whatever I want. But the in cargo means you're gonna spawn in the cargo seat of the vehicle that is in your group. And if I'm set to flying here, obviously for air vehicles, if I want to play a chopper mission or a jet mission, and I don't have a runway like on the map here where I can actually start my aircraft, then I can set it to flying. And as soon as I start the mission, I'm already gonna be airborne. But this is for air vehicles, obviously. So I'm gonna leave it to none here. No problem. Here I can give my unit a name. I can type something. This is especially is very important if you could go into the scripting, because for some scripts you actually need to have in the script, you need the unit name for it to correspond with each other. And then I need here to put a name to this particular unit. I'm not gonna go into that scripting now, so it's not necessary to have a name. Here the skill level, obviously not important for the unit I am gonna be playing, because I can change the bar as much as I want. I'm not gonna be a better player that way. But here I can set the skill level of AI. So if I want the mission not to be too hard, I can like take the bar down for the enemy units. I can raise the bar for my friendly units. Yeah, I guess you see the point. Alright, that's the basic stuff here. Then the initialization field. This is where you use scripts to, like, if you want to change the equipment of this unit, or yeah, there's a lot of different scripts. The description here, that's what you especially need if you're doing a multiplayer mission. So as I explained before, here is if the unit is playable and it's selectable in the multiplayer lobby, here the description is gonna be what's gonna be written there in the lobby. So if I create myself a sniper here, for example, I can here write sniper, or I can write a call sign or whatever, and when I go into multiplayer lobby, it's gonna say sniper. So I see, oh, okay, this is a sniper character, this is an engineer character, as you want. These three bars down here, health armor, as you can see, if I want to have like only 60% health at mission start, I can do that here. If I want my vehicle to have not full fuel, I can also decrease the bar. I can reduce ammunition at mission start. It's all doable here. And then we get here probability of presence. I also never used that actually. So I guess if you have enemy units and you go here, you decrease the bar, maybe they're not gonna spawn, or I have no idea what the hell it does. Never used it. Placement radius, I guess if you set it to 100, the unit is gonna be spawning in a radius of 100 meters from where you actually have placed it here in the editor. But also here I can't tell you for sure, never used it. And what you see here, this like clock face thing, is the direction the unit is gonna be looking at mission start. So if I have it here set to 12 o'clock, it's just gonna look north, and I can change this here to 130 degrees now, whatever I want. If I go to OK, you see now my unit has spawned, the corpsman that I've selected. The red circle here means it's the player, the player character, and you see now it's looking here towards this, it's looking to the right here pretty much, which is the angle that I gave him to look at. Alright, so if I set it here to the other direction and I select here playable, it's gonna tell me that no player is selected because I've set it to playable. And you see now here the circle that was red before is now like, yeah, pink or whatever. So this indicates me that this unit is a playable character, and if it's red around here, the circle is red, it's the player character. And you see now the guy is looking in another direction. So that's already pretty much it for how to create yourself a unit. As you see here now, it's nothing. If I go to player, you see this button appears, preview. This is like launch the mission, go into the mission and test out what you have created here before. You need to have a player selected obviously to launch the mission. And I advise you guys, no matter what you want to do on a map, always just like create yourself some sort of unit that is selected player, because otherwise you're gonna constantly have like these pop-up messages like you just saw it before. So even if you want to like just create yourself a base, just do a character first, place them somewhere in the outskirts here where it doesn't bother you, work on your stuff, and if you want to look in game what you have created, just drag and drop it to the location where you wanted to spawn and preview the mission. But I would always start with creating yourself a character, because otherwise you're constantly gonna have these annoying pop-up messages that tell you that there's no player selected. That's really annoying after a while. Alright? Okay, well, you've seen here I've dragged this character around very easy. It's like, yeah, the standard stuff on your keyboard. It's like if you're writing a letter or whatever in your Word or so. I can, by clicking on it with the left mouse button, I can like grab it, I can move it around, releasing the left mouse button, it's gonna stay there. Alright, by clicking and holding the right mouse button, I'm like grabbing the map, and then I can move around on the map. With the mouse wheel, I can zoom in, zoom out. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I can delete units by also like marking them by clicking on it, press delete while I'm still hovering with the cursor over it, and it's gonna be deleted. I can also mark something here by holding the left mouse button. You see here this like square appears, the green square. If I have multiple units, I can I can select multiple units with this, and then I can move them around. So I just create a group real quick. I can mark the whole group. I can grab them. Need to go to F1 again. I can grab them, and then I can place them somewhere else on the map. I can delete them individually or by marking all and holding the left shift button and delete. I can delete the whole group. Very easy. Another thing I can do is like copy and paste stuff. I can mark this group, Control C, Control V, and I can repeat that as often as I want. So instead of always going into the groups menu, double click and OK, I can just Control C stuff. Control C, Control V, very easy. Alright. Another thing that I can do is if I want my unit to be facing in another direction, I can, like I explained before, either double click on the unit again and change it in here, or I can also use the right shift button, hold the right shift key, and then hold the left mouse button. And then this way I can, by like turning around, I can turn the unit to the direction I want it to be facing on mission start. So that's pretty much what you need to navigate on the map, to set your characters where you want them. All right. Okay, let's do a quick preview. All right, you see now I'm here, the Corpsman, the character I have selected as player. And here in front of me you see the group that I have created. Just like this USMC infantry group. And you see the characters are spawning in a V formation, which is that's the default one. So they're not spawning on the spot where they were on the map. They're automatically gonna spawn in this formation. Okay, so what I'm going to show you now is the playable character that we have before. I'm just going to select the unit here, go to playable, and I'm going to take the squad leader 2, playable. You see now the red one here is me, the player, and the pink ones are the playable units. Go to preview again, and I'm going to start as this unit here. And now by hitting the T key, T like Tango, on your keyboard, you get in the team switch menu here. And now here I get the Corpsman, which I'm in here, player. And oh my god, my neighbor is drilling something. Sorry about that. Yeah, the Corpsman. And then I can select another unit like squad leader, group leader, AI. You see here on the minimap it shows me where this unit is. This is me. The green one is the character I have selected. I can go to view unit. Then the camera moves like over. And I see now that here in the background I see the character that, where I'm gonna spawn to. I can either go back, so leave the menu, or I can switch. And as you see now, I'm the squad leader here. On the bottom you see all the units in my group, so I can lead them now. And yeah, I can press T again, go to the rifleman. Here again, this is me right now. Here is this this rifleman. I can view the unit if I want, or I can switch to it. And now I'm here, this AT soldier. So this can be a lot of fun for your single player mission. If you like, don't trust the AI with their support and stuff, you can play as a ground troop, and then you can switch to a chopper or to a jet, or yeah, or you can switch from infantry to tanks. Yeah, whatever the hell you want to do. All right. So that's for team switch. This isn't single player, like I said before. Multiplayer, you can't use that. The multiplayer used the playable characters here for the slots of your mission. Okay. Yeah, I'm already talking for almost 20 minutes now, so I'm gonna cut it off here. And yeah, make some more parts, because I don't want to overwhelm you with like a tutorial that goes on for an hour. So we make this part 2 here with the units and team switch, and then I'm gonna make another part for the groups. And yeah, I don't know how to split it up yet, but I don't want to make tutorials that go on for hours, because already this was maybe but a piece of information. But yeah, I hope you guys go actually on the editor, try this stuff out yourself, and already try maybe something that I haven't explained yet. So it's not gonna be all new in the next part, because it's not that hard actually. I used the editor for almost 10 years since Operation Flashpoint 1. So I'm used to the basic stuff, but I teach myself everything by myself, because I didn't have like anyone who could explain me this. So I just spent ages in the editor and figured out most of the things myself, or I was like just browsing the internet for help. But it's actually doable. Alright, so this is it for this part 2 here, and as always, stay tuned for the next for my next upload. Please visit and like my Facebook page, link in the description, because I'm constantly posting things on there, latest uploads and new planned projects and other activities. So if you don't have a YouTube account and can't subscribe to my channel, you might want to use this option to stay up to date with my uploads. All right. So yeah, thanks a lot, and see you guys later.